So yeah, good morning students. Here I'll welcome you at today's virtual session. So our today's topic is the Silver House. Today's topic is the Silver House. That in an introduction part we have learned the importance of the moon and why all the kids are very close to the moon, and there are various festivals just like your Ramzan Eid, even Sankashti Chaturthi. On this some occasion there is a great importance of the moon. Okay, so and even in EVS 1 and even in geography you have also learned about that moon is a natural satellite of the earth. Everything we have learned, but here we are going to learn about the imagination of a moon in a very different way. And this poem is written by Dilio. And who is he? That he is graduated from the London School of Economics and Political Science and University of London with a BSc in Economics before gaining MSc in Economics. Means what he has completed is education in politics as well as in economics also. And even when he completed in 1967, okay, 1997, he got his retirement. So in 2003, he was a professor of criminology at Middlesex University. This is the name of the university. And he was is continuously visiting a professor at the University of Springer, Leicester, Loampton, and Goldsmiths. This is a university, all these universities of London. So in such a way, the John Lee is a poet, and we got the information about him. So what is meant by this Silver House? So first, there is a silver house in the lovely sky, as round as a silver crown. It takes 2 weeks, it build it up, and 2 to pull it down. So it means this here, students, the poet says that there is a silver house in the lovely sky. So there is a silver house in the lovely sky. It means that the poet wanted, they are imagining a moon, imagining this moon as it is a house, that it is a house in the sky. Someone is living there, and it looks like a round as silver as a crown. Round as a silver crown. So silver crown means what, students? It's a coin which is used in England, just like in India how we have a 5 rupees coin, we have a 1 rupees coin, we have a 2 rupees coin. In the same way, this coin is used in England. And what is the shape of that house in the sky? Is just same as means it just look as a silver crown which is used in England. And it takes 2 weeks to build it up and two to pull it down. So students, in last year, even in EVS 1 and even in the geography, you have learned about the waning of a moon. So waning of moon means shape of the moon starts decreasing, and the waxing of the moon means the shape starts increasing. Okay, so these are what the waxing and mooning, waxing and waning. Waning, the position, the phases of the waning of the moon, it takes 2 weeks, and for the waxing of the moon, it also 2 weeks. So that's the poet is saying that this house in the sky, if they wanted to build up, it takes 2 weeks, means just like a waxing of the moon, polluted dawn means it's just a waning of the moon. Then that second one, there is a man who lives in the silver house in a lonely sort of way, but what his name is no one knows or no one likes to say. So it means that students, the here the poet is assuming that, see in this picture also they have assumed that there is a one person who are living in this sky, who are living in this sky, and in that house this is the only one person, only one person is living there, but he was only lonely, and other than him no one lives there and stays there, but no one knows what his name, because we knows very well, because the moon is very far away from us, so we are not knowing it, that who is living there. We don't know the name of that person who are living there, and even no one likes to see that also, that who are that person. Okay, now here next, yet when you go to bed tonight, just draw the window blind and peep out at the silver moon, this lonely man to find. But if his house is taken down and all the sky is bare, then go to bed, because of course the poor man won't be there. So it means that student, here the poet wanted to say that when we go to bed, when we go to bed, so whatever work, we have to draw a window. We have to draw a window of the silver house, and we have to peep. Peep means to look inside. Peep out means to look, means the person who was inside this house, he wanted to see outside. So that's why we are supposed to draw a window. It means that if the person is here, he can look out from here, so that easily we can find out the man in the silver moon. And students, if this house is totally get blind, if this house is not in the sky, so that all the sky become bare. Here bare means empty. Bare means empty. Understood, student? So just think about ourselves only. If there is no moon in the sky, at that time you can see only stars in the sky, and the whole sky, it become empty. It's bare. So that's why now, if this moon is not there in the sky, so it means that now it's time to go to bed. It's time to go to bed means it's time to sleep, because the poor man won't be there. It means there were no person on this moon. Okay, students, now. Students, so today's another new topic is the I rhyming word. This is I rhyming words. So I rhyming words are words which in this whole spelling is same, only one spelling is get different. Just like a door, it's a poor. So in this case, D and double O R, double O R, double O R is there, and only one,
letter gets changed. So that's why it is a I rhyming word. So that's why it is called it as a rhyming words. Another I rhyming is the down and the blown. Down, blown. So here O-W-N, O-W-N is there. But yes, spelling is correct, but the pronunciation is different. So that's why this is from our eyes, we come to know that it is a rhyming word. But it cannot spelt just like other words, just sit, heat, not this. Cat, sat is a rhyming word. But I rhyming words are rhyming words which end. These words ended with the same spelling, but the pronunciation is different because the another words or two different letters get added, or this words get started with the other words or the other letters. Okay, so these are the I rhyming words. So we are going to see that their evaluation period. Okay. Fine. Now here I'll ask to the roll number 8, 9. Vidisha Gaikwad.
Teacher.
Read this poem. Read this question.
Evaluation. Answer the following questions. First, what is in the lovely sky?
What is in the lovely sky?
There is a silver house in the lovely sky.
There is a silver house
in the lovely sky.
Lovely sky. Very good. Very good. And just mute yourself.
Thank you, teacher.
Now here again,